Very special program tonight. Stephen Hawking is a theoretical physicist. He was the Lucasian Professor of Mathematics at the University of Cambridge for 30 years. He's the 2009 recipient of the Presidential Medal of Freedom and co-author of a brilliant and controversial new book, The Grand Design. And we welcome him back to Larry King Live. We have a series of questions planned. Let's get right to it. Stephen, why is it important to find the grand design of our universe?
I believe everyone should have a broad picture of how the universe operates and our place in it. It is a basic human desire, and it also puts our other worries in perspective.
You say that science can explain the universe without the need for a creator. Well, what is that explanation? Why is there something instead of nothing?
Gravity and quantum theory cause universes to be created spontaneously out of nothing.
You write that because there is a law such as gravity, the universe can and will create itself from nothing. Will you tell me how that law came into existence?
Gravity is a consequence of M theory, which is the only possible unified theory. It is like saying, why is 2 plus 2?
For. I guess simply put, do you believe in God?
God may exist, but science can explain the universe without the need for a creator.
So he may exist. I'll pick up on that with the panel. Your book has stirred a lot of controversy. Why do you think people react so strongly to your contention that it's not necessary to invoke God to explain the creation of the universe?
Science is increasingly answering questions that used to be the province of religion.
One of your colleagues at Cambridge says that science provides us with a narrative as to how existence may happen, but theology addresses the meaning of the narrative. How do you respond to that?
The scientific account is complete. Theology is unnecessary.
Pretty directly put. What gives your life, your existence, meaning?
I have a full and satisfying life. My work and my family are very important to me.
You recently said that you see great dangers for the human race. What are the sources of these dangers? Is it mankind itself or external factors?
We are in danger of destroying ourselves by our greed and stupidity. We cannot remain looking inwards at ourselves on a small, an increasingly polluted and overcrowded planet.
Well, then, what are mankind's chances of surviving these dangers?
If we can get through the next few hundred years, we should have spread out into space. Then, an isolated disaster will not wipe out the entire human race.
Now we got to get through the next 200 years, though. We'll be right back with more of